Hey guys, back with another Borderlands 2 Guns and Weapons Countdown, and today I figured it could be fun to go over some of what I think are the rarest and hardest weapons to get in Borderlands 2. Now before we start, this video will be going over weapons that I would consider to be very rare and or difficult to acquire for a variety of reasons. Some of these weapons are just rare and have relatively low drop rates from their respective drops, while others require you to spawn a specific boss or enemy that rarely appears. Either way, I think you'll spend a fair amount of time trying to farm for all of the weapons on this list. But without further ado, these will be the top 10 rarest and hardest guns and weapons to get in Borderlands 2, starting now. Number 10, the Stink Pot. The Stink Pot, along with the Pot of Gold Shield, are frustrating to acquire because they only drop from specific mini-bosses that don't respawn. In the case of the Stink Pot, it only drops from Nobeard, who will appear at the very beginning of the Captain Scarlet and her Pirate's Booty DLC. Unfortunately, because Nobeard only spawns once per playthrough, you will have to either get lucky and have him drop the gun for you, or you will have to reset your playthrough and then fight him over and over until you can get the version that you want. As for the weapon itself, it's actually relatively decent in terms of damage. Provided that you've specced and you've got a Rifleman class mod on your commando, you may find that the damage it can deal is pretty good. At the same time, the inability to perform critical hits definitely is a drawback. Still, out of all of the weapons on this list, I would argue that this one is probably the easiest to get at Ultimate Vault Hunter mode and up. Now, if you're playing true Vault Hunter mode and under, your chances of getting one decreases significantly, as you can't reset your playthrough. Number 9, the Godfinger / Becca. While I suppose I could also include the Carnage and Wanderlust in this entry, I figured that the Godfinger and Becca are the only two second generation pearlescents that you're really going to want. The Godfinger is a sniper rifle that will deal increasing damage the further away you are from enemies, while the Becca is an assault rifle that will fire an initial projectile that splits twice. The first split occurs where one projectile travels at normal speed while the other stops midair. Then the second split occurs with the suspended second projectile, which will suddenly start to travel and then split into three additional projectiles. This effectively allows you to fire roughly four shots at the cost of one bullet. Both of these weapons are hard to get because you have to find tubby enemies and you have to be level 62 or higher in order for the weapons to actually drop from said enemies. And unlike first generation pearlescents like the Stalker, Butcher, or Avenger, which can drop from any suitable loot source, only tubby enemies appear to be able to drop the Godfinger, Becca, Wanderlust, and Carnage. So you're going to have to get lucky and hope you come across a tubby, and then hope it drops a second generation pearlescent to get your Becca, Godfinger, Wanderlust, or Carnage. Number 8, the Twister. This weapon is difficult to acquire because it requires the player to level up a badass savage to Omid Omidok, or aka Triple O, from the Sir Hammerlock's Big Game Hunt DLC. Unlike leveling up a God Liath, a Witch Doctor will need to be present to level the badass savage up, which, as you will soon discover, becomes a real pain in the butt. Even if you get Triple O to spawn, there's also not a guarantee that the Twister will actually drop, so you could spend countless hours farming for this gun. Though, out of all of the weapons showcased this far, the Twister is definitely worth having. While its projectile pattern is unconventional, it's a Jacob's shotgun and shock element that's perfect for Anarchy Gage. At higher stacks of Anarchy, the Twister's projectile pattern is seemingly unaffected and can be used for quick hip firing to deal massive damage to enemies. The sad thing is that I wish this weapon was a little easier to acquire because it is so good. Now, it would be one thing if Triple O was easier to spawn or if it was a guaranteed drop upon killing him. Ultimately though, the difficulty in spawning Triple O is what makes the Twister so difficult to get. Number 7, the Norfleet. While some may groan at the Norfleet's inclusion, if you were to acquire the Norfleet by spawning and farming Vermivorous, then it's fair to say that this weapon is both quite rare and quite difficult to acquire. After all, you will need four players in your game, and then you will need to get lucky and hope a Varkid evolves from adult to badass to super badass to ultra badass and then into Vermivorous. From there, you'll need to get lucky and actually get the Norfleet to drop. Now with this said, farming the Norfleet from Hyperius is much easier, and while the weapon is still relatively rare, you can at least farm Hyperius for a Norfleet by yourself. Especially if you've got zero spec for boar, and you're using a shotgun-like weapon and some singularity grenades. As for the weapon itself, like the Twister, the Norfleet is definitely a weapon that you will want. If you're unfamiliar with Borderlands 2, the Norfleet is by far the most powerful rocket launcher in the game, and is the equivalent of the BFG 9000 from Doom. Plus, you can get this weapon in all elements, which makes this weapon useful against pretty much anything. The Norfleet is a great weapon, and while it's fairly rare and difficult to acquire, you definitely want this gun. Number 6, the Ogre. In my personal opinion, while the Ogre is a good assault rifle, I would actually say that the amount of damage that it deals doesn't really make it worth the effort of trying to obtain. First, you will need the Dragonkeep DLC, and then you will need to spawn an enemy named Warlord Slog, who happens to only appear during the badass round of the Magic Slaughterdome challenge located in Murderland's Temple. And unlike Triple O, who can be spawned from any badass savage, and unlike Vermivorous, who can feasibly spawn from any Varkid, Warlord Slog must be spawned specifically during the badass round of the Murderland Slaughterdome. Even then, there is no guarantee that you will actually get the Ogre to drop. Like I said before, while I would argue that the Ogre is certainly not a bad weapon, I don't think it's really good enough to actually justify the challenge required to obtain it. And if you're looking for a good assault rifle, you would probably be better off with the Kitten or Hail. And the Hail in particular is vastly superior in my opinion, and is acquired from the Slaughterdome in the fridge. After all, it's hard for the Ogre to compete with the Hail's superior crit bonus and its healing capabilities. It's really up to you if you want to try and get this gun. It's not necessarily bad, but there are definitely other assault rifles out there that I think are much better. Number 5, the Chopper. So the Chopper is actually a returning weapon from the first Borderlands, and unfortunately, it's not really useful on most characters other than Salvador due to the fact that most characters can't cope with the insane amount of ammo consumption that the Chopper requires. Salvador has the benefit of being able to regenerate ammo both through Gunzerking and also by equipping a Hoarder class mod. So again, if you're any other character than Salvador, the Chopper is going to be awful. Additionally, the Chopper is also quite difficult to acquire as it only drops from Dexiduous the Invincible from Sir Hammerlock's Big Game Hunt DLC, and not only will you need to drop about 99 Iridium every time you want to spawn him, but like many of the other weapons on this list, there is no guarantee that the Chopper will actually drop from Dexiduous even if you beat him. So essentially, what you have is a weapon that's only good on one character and drops from a boss that is expensive to spawn and difficult to kill. Ultimately, it's sad because the Chopper is actually a pretty cool concept, but unfortunately, it's just too expensive to use. Number 4, the Hive Launcher. Maybe it's just me, but I think I've only seen the Hive rocket launcher drop once in all of my playthroughs. I don't know if there is some kind of bug that is preventing the Hive from dropping more frequently or what, but I would argue that the legendary invader sniper that also drops from Saturn is far more common, and farming for an invader sniper seems like a reasonable goal to me. However, farming for a Hive rocket launcher just seems like an exercise in masochism. Unlike the Chopper, the Hive launcher is actually quite good, and while it does have a slight learning curve, as long as you remember to always shoot it at the floor, I think you'll find that the homing projectiles will always tend to properly seek out and hit enemies. Plus, you will also find that the Hive can benefit from things like the Bee Shield, which will apply full amp damage to each homing projectile, and the Grog Nozzle, which will allow you to fire multiple balls for an insane number of homing projectiles on screen. While I wish fire, shock, and slag variants of the Hive launcher existed, the corrosive version is still quite powerful provided it's properly buffed with the correct gear. But if you do want this launcher, you'll have to get lucky while killing Saturn, who is located in the arid Nexus Badlands. Number 3, the Teeth of Terramorphis. So the Teeth of Terramorphis is one of the few unique weapons in the game that I'm not entirely sure I've ever seen drop. As the name would imply, this shotgun is supposed to drop from Terramorphous and is one of his unique pieces of loot, along with other items like the Slayer of Terramorphous class mod, the Hide of Terramorphous shield, and the Breath of Terramorphous grenade mod. While the legendaries themselves are fairly easy to find among the pile of loot that drops after Terra's death, the Teeth of Terramorphous is a blue rarity weapon, and thus it has a tendency to blend in with the other blue rarity weapons. As for the weapon itself, the Teeth of Terramorphous is fairly difficult to use. This is because the weapon's projectile pattern follows a teeth chomping motion in a horizontal line. Still, I'd say while the Teeth of Terramorphous wouldn't be my go-to shotgun, I would say that it's definitely better than something like the Wanderlust, the Landscaper, and other similarly awful weapons. It's a shame that this weapon is so rare and that the projectile pattern is spread so wide. It would have been a lot cooler if this projectile pattern was smaller and much more contained, like your more standard shotguns. That way, it could have proven to actually be pretty powerful. But if you want to drive yourself crazy, try farming for the Teeth of Terramorphous. Number 2, the Cobra. The Cobra is infamous among the community because at one time, it was arguably the rarest weapon in the game. It's a shame too, because a lot of the people at the time were clamoring for an explosive sniper rifle, only for the explosive sniper rifle to release with the Torgue DLC and have the weapon have a less than 1% chance to drop every time a specific enemy would drop a sniper rifle. Fortunately, dual duping was and is a thing, and it's also nice Gearbox went back and tweaked the drop rate a little bit to make the weapon slightly more common. Now, the Cobra is a nice sniper rifle, but it's a little overrated in my opinion. My main objection is that the Cobra is a bolt-action sniper rifle, while the original one from Borderlands 1 was a semi-auto sniper rifle. Still, I think you'll find that this weapon could be a nice sniper for mobbing on Maya, provided that you've specced for Ruin and Converge. That way, you can take advantage of the splash damage that the Cobra deals from its explosion. I don't know if I would recommend this weapon because it is still really hard to get legitimately, but if you do want one, you could do a bunch of runs of the beatdown from Torg's Campaign of Carnage, and it should eventually turn up. Number 1, the Diamond Weissenheimer. So, this final entry in our countdown is a bit more complex. Ultimately, the Diamond Weissenheimer is rare, but I specifically chose it because it's the most famous version of a specific type of weapon that can appear in Borderlands 2. And to explain what I mean, non-unique SMGs in Borderlands 2 with the Malawan barrel are typically non-elemental, while Malawan versions are always going to have an element. However, elemental SMGs with the Malawan barrel from manufacturers other than Malawan do exist, and the Weissenheimer just so happens to be a Hyperion Malawan barreled SMG that comes in corrosive. The shock version is called the Storm, the fire version is called the Backburner, and the slag version is called the Wellness. The Malawan barrel tends to produce different names on all Malawan barreled SMGs, so you can have the shock element Eel from Dahl, the fire element Kindle from Tedior, and the slag elemental Revenant from Malawan. Even still, non-Malawan manufactured SMGs that have both a Malawan barrel and an element are much rarer than their Malawan manufactured counterparts. Therefore, a gemstone variant of a weapon like this is even rarer. So, whether you got a Diamond Weissenheimer, a Cubic Zirconia Kindle, an Emerald Eel, a Quartz Slaggy, and whatever other permutations that you can think of, these weapons are arguably among the rarest weapons in the game. Keep in mind too that you could feasibly feed Butt Stallion and get a non-gemstone version of either the Weissenheimer, Kindle, Eel, Slaggy, and other similar weapons. Like all gemstone weapons though, you can get this from feeding Butt Stallion Iridium, and you're probably going to go through a lot of Iridium farming for these weapons. But alright guys, I think that's going to pretty much wrap up this particular video. If you like this video, feel free to leave a like, click the bell to join the notification squad, and as always, take care, and I'll see y'all next time.